While detecting an outright alien civilization may prove difficult, detecting life itself on exoplanets may not be. As I've discussed in other videos, there are signatures that biology leaves in the composition of an exoplanet's atmosphere that could indicate that it's inhabited. How advanced that life would be, or what comprises it, would remain an unknown, unless something very specific like the vegetative red edge appears, indicating the presence of analogs of plant life. But these are not the only indicators that one might see. In a paper by Stephanie Olson and colleagues, link below, they detail a new biosignature that astronomers might look for when studying exoplanets, particularly those using the coming James Webb Space Telescope. The problem with some of the biosignatures is that they are only partial indicators. This includes the gases oxygen and methane. On Earth, biology creates them, and they have largely defined Earth's current atmospheric makeup. This is an atmosphere extremely altered by photosynthesis. Trouble is, there can be non-biological sources for both oxygen and methane, so you would need some further indicator to pin the presence of them down to life. The authors of the paper provide just that. They suggest we look for seasons on exoplanets and look for minute changes in atmospheric composition that would come with that. For Earth, this means that areas where it's summer and plant life is generally more active, you end up with just a bit more oxygen in the atmosphere in that area than you would see in winter, along with a bit less carbon dioxide. This should work the same for exoplanets, and with sensitive enough instruments should be detectable. And depending on what gases might be seen, it could conceivably reveal clues into the actual biochemistry that's going on with that alien life. As an aside, I wonder if biosignatures won't be the first detection of alien life that we see. Of course, SETI could pick up a radio signal tomorrow, or some future mission to places like Europa might bear fruit, but those require resources, alien or down here on Earth, to do, and those may not be forthcoming. But detecting the effects of photosynthesis on an alien world should soon be within our capability, and if analogs of plant life on Earth are common in the universe, they may be among the first things we see. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently angry at the plants again. It may be that we will someday be able to tell them, you are not alone, we have discovered exoplanets, and not a single one of them is going to care. The hubris of the plants knows no bounds. Time to eat another retribution salad. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.